Hello everyone, my name is Sohaib Katariwala and I am an Analytics Specialist Solutions Architect with AWS. I'm joined with my colleague Sam Selvin, who is also an Analytics Specialist Solutions Architect with AWS. Today we will be giving you a demo of the new streaming ingestion feature of Amazon Redshift. There are existing solutions to ingest streaming data into Amazon Redshift, such as Amazon Kinesis Firehose, that have been available for some time now. Customers have been asking us for a way to increase the throughput and latency of streaming data ingested into Amazon Redshift. This was a key driver for us to create the new native streaming ingestion feature for Amazon Redshift. With Redshift streaming ingestion, the latency of your streaming data goes from minutes to seconds. Redshift streaming ingestion is entirely configurable with SQL, which makes it very easy to use. You can define a schema for your streaming data or choose to ingest semi-structured JSON data with the Redshift super data type. Now, Sam will show you how it works. First of all, we need streaming data. You can use existing Kinesis data streams that you have. For this demo, we'll create a new data stream. We will use a publicly available tool that the Kinesis team has created called the Amazon Kinesis Data Generator. It allows you to create a template for your JSON payload using some functions from the Faker Python package that generates fake data for you. Once we have a template, we click on Send Data to start generating and sending data to a Kinesis data stream. Now, Sam will jump over to the Redshift query editor and connect to a Redshift cluster. The first thing he'll do is create an external schema from Kinesis. To create the external schema from Kinesis, he'll give the external schema a unique and descriptive name. Then he will specify that this external schema is from Kinesis. And finally, he will specify an IAM role that Redshift will assume to access the Kinesis data streams. This role must have access to read the data stream as well as list the streams that you plan on ingesting into Amazon Redshift. Here is an example of the IAM role policy we are using for this demo. You can see that this role is allowed to describe stream summary, get shard iterator, get records, and describe stream. This role is also allowed to list stream and list shards for all streams just for the purpose of this demo. Once the external schema is created, Sam will enable case sensitivity for identifiers in Redshift. This is because Kinesis stream names are case sensitive. Next, we want to specify which data stream we'd like to ingest into Amazon Redshift. We do this by creating a materialized view in our external schema from the Kinesis data stream that we want to ingest. Make sure to use the exact stream name within double quotes, keeping case sensitivity in mind. Now, let's look at what goes in the select statement in our materialized view definition when ingesting from Kinesis data streams. The first four columns are approximate arrival timestamp, partition key, shard ID, and sequence number. These are metadata columns that are available by default for all Kinesis data streams. They are helpful for auditing, troubleshooting, and monitoring your streaming data. The payload column contains the actual data in the payload of the data stream. In this case, we are choosing to ingest the entire payload into a super data type column in our materialized view. Sam will run the statement to create the materialized view. It is important to note that creating the materialized view doesn't actually populate the data from the Kinesis data stream into Amazon Redshift. Once the materialized view is created, we need to refresh the materialized view to pull the data from the Kinesis data stream into Amazon Redshift. Sam will now run the refresh materialized view command to pull the data from the Kinesis data stream and materialize it in the materialized view. The first time you refresh a materialized view after creating it from a Kinesis data stream, Redshift will go back to the trim horizon of your data and pull all the data from that point in your data stream. Depending on how long the data has been streaming, it may take longer for the first refresh to pull all the data from the trim horizon compared to subsequent refreshes of your materialized view. Once the materialized view is refreshed, SAM will run a query to check the max and min approximate arrival timestamp of the data. We can see that the minimum timestamp goes back to when the Kinesis data generator started streaming data into this data stream, and the max timestamp is just around a few seconds prior to the current time on SAM's computer. Next, SAM will select the payload from this materialized view, and we can see the JSON objects generated by the data generator and published into the data stream are now in our materialized view as a super data type. SAM will now navigate to the data generator, where he has created another data stream that is also called EV station data, but it has mixed case letters in the name. He will now create a materialized view from this different data stream. For this new materialized view, SAM is not storing the entire JSON payload into a single super data type column. For this stream, the schema is well-defined, and he knows the schema of the data that will be streaming, so he will use Redshift's built-in JSON functions to extract specific fields from the JSON and store them into separate columns in the materialized view. Here, he is also able to define specific columns as distribution keys and sort key, just like he could in any other materialized view or table in Amazon Redshift. He will now create this materialized view and refresh it to pull the data from the Kinesis data stream into Amazon Redshift. Since the refresh materialized view command will only pull the data from the Kinesis data stream once, you can create a schedule to refresh the materialized view to pull data from your Kinesis data streams into Amazon Redshift as frequently as you like. SAM will now show you how to schedule the refresh materialized view query using the Redshift query editor. He'll navigate to the Amazon Redshift console and click on his Redshift cluster. From there, he'll click the Query Data drop-down button on the top right of the page and select Query in Query Editor. Here, he'll connect to his Redshift cluster, and in the Query Editor, he'll paste the Refresh Materialized View command for a specific materialized view that he created earlier. He'll then click on Schedule and provide all the necessary permissions as well as scheduling options. In this case, he's going to schedule the materialized view to refresh every 2 minutes and click on Save Changes. Now this materialized view will be refreshed every 2 minutes by Amazon Redshift, which means Redshift will pull in all the new data that was published to the Kinesis data streams since the last time the materialized view was refreshed. Now, SAM will run a query against the new materialized view to aggregate the data. In this query, he is converting the connection time from the materialized view to a timestamp data type. This is because timestamp data types are not currently supported for the materialized view. He is also adding up the kilowatt hours delivered as the energy consumed and counting the distinct users. He's also filtering the data to only look at the last 5 minutes of activity. He will now run the query, and the result will display how many users have connected to the charging station and how much energy they have consumed per second over the past 5 minutes. We can see in the result that each row represents a second, and we can see the total number of users connected to the charging station along with the total energy consumed in kilowatt hours. SAM will now create a new view on top of the materialized view to convert the connection time field from a string to a timestamp data type. Here he can apply other business logic as well in this view if he would like to, and use it for his downstream analytics. This was a demonstration of how you can use the new streaming ingestion feature of Amazon Redshift to ingest streaming data from Kinesis data streams into Amazon Redshift directly. Thank you all for watching.